Past District Governor Ravi Vadlamani, a chartered accountant by profession. Past District Governor Ravi Vadlamani, a chartered accountant by profession.
Fault in the video. Some fault in the video. One second.
Yes, sir.
There's a fault in the video. Just give me a minute.
Take it from YouTube. You know, can we do something else? Can we put the spot on Kamal? Can we put the spot on Director Kamal? Narendra?
Past District Governor Ravi Vadlamani is a chartered accountant by profession. He's a part.
Narendra.
Anu, you're done with your.
One second.
No, you know what? If we can't do that, I'll request Kamal, the current director, to introduce the incoming director. So can you put the spot on Kamal?
I think Sandeep, in a minute, it should be resolved.
Yeah, if you can just give me a minute, I'll just resolve it. Just give me a minute.
So meanwhile, friends, we have these results. But you know, I want that we should put a spot on each of them. Kamal, would you like to say something for Ravi meanwhile?
Yeah, I would love to say something for Ravi. You know, there are a few individuals in this world who not only think big, they dream big, but they put a foundation below their dreams. Ravi is one of those individuals who not only dreams big, but makes sure that all his dreams come true. So this is one man who's a single man army. I mean, he's done unbelievable projects. If you talk about setting up benches, he is the bench babu of the country. I mean, probably he's done 10 lakh benches in the schools up till now. If you talk about setting up water harvesting projects, he's probably done borewells of nearly about 100,000 borewells across the country. This is the type. And if you talk about happy schools, he's probably done about 100 happy schools. So everything is in large. He's a person of a large magnitude, a larger than life personality, a personality not only inspires other people, but he always carries them with them. He creates a path for other people to join his journey of excellence. So I would always, and he's a great friend. I've been working with him for years together. And Ravi and Raji, and Ravi, congratulations. And let us all give him a big congratulations, because I think after becoming the director, this is the first time he's coming to the district. So warm, warm, hearty welcome to you, Ravi. And may God bless you and may you succeed in all your endeavors. And may you take us along in your journey of excellence.
Thank you, Kamal. Thank you, Kamal. Narendra, have you got that going? Yeah. Oh, great.
Past District Governor Ravi Vadlamani, a chartered accountant by profession. Partner in leading firm of chartered accountants, Uma Maheshwar Rao and Company. He was the regional council member of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. A senior Rotary leader, District Governor in the year 2001-2002. As Governor, was adjudged the best governor in the entire Rotary world, was awarded the Golden Globe at Barcelona, Spain International Convention, as District Governor collected the highest amount for the Rotary Foundation in Zones 4, 5 and 6. He's an Endowment and Major Gift Advisor, Zone 5, for 4 years, 2013 to 2017. International Training Leader, 2014. member of Audit Committee for Rotary International and the Rotary Foundation for 6 years from 2013 to 2019. Currently, is the Vice Chairman of the Audit Committee. A facilitator for RRFCs and EMGAs for 2 years. His spouse, PDG Rajalakshmi, is an accomplished past governor. She's also an international training leader, recipient of the Service Above Self Award, the Regional Polio Free Award, and Citation for Meritorious Service Award and Distinguished Service Award. The couple are members of the Arch Clum Society. PDG Ravi Vadlamani received the Service Above Self Award from Rotary International, the Citation for Meritorious Service Award from the Rotary Foundation, the Distinguished Service Award by the Rotary Foundation, and the Regional Polio Free Award by the Rotary Foundation. He was the chairman of a very successful zone institute, Namaste Hyderabad. Also in the core committee of several institutes and literacy conferences, and chairman of Lakshya, the training meeting for governors-elect. Also, the governors-elect training leader at Dubai Zone Institute. He was awarded honorary doctorate for service by the Acharya Nagarjuna University. Ravi is passionate to do good in the world through the Rotary Foundation. He has monitored and implemented several large projects like providing more than 100,000 school desks, several hundred sanitation blocks and group washing stations in schools, more than 10,000 handwells in thousands of villages, 500 reverse osmosis plants in villages, more than 1,000 open wells, hundreds of irrigation wells, several lift irrigation schemes to provide water for the farmer. He has also provided 50 mini protected water schemes and 50 overhead reservoirs in villages, provided more than 10,000 sewing machines for the underprivileged women, provided more than 10,000 tricycles, and provided thousands of milk cattle. During the tsunami, he has provided thousands of boats and constructed more than 30 school buildings. He has also built 1,000 houses for the poor. Ravi started his Rotary journey as a Raila participant in the year 1973. He went as a GSC team leader in 1989 to Atlanta, USA. He served as a Rotaract president in the year 1978, a faculty member of the International Raila. He has attended 18 Rotary International conventions and chaired several breakout sessions at these conventions. He has addressed several international conferences in USA, Australia, UK and Finland, has attended 18 zone institutes and 10 international institutes. He's an accomplished speaker and has addressed several hundreds of district seminars, training events, conferences and assemblies. He has represented Rotary International President several times, including at Lahore and Finland. He was in the Rotary International Committees from 2002 continuously. He's a past president of Roundtable India, is the chairman of Indian Red Cross Guntur branch. He's been honored with 13 gold medals in various years by governors of Andhra Pradesh. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome past district governor Ravi Vadlamani.
That was fabulous. It's all to Ravi. Can you put the spot on Ravi Narada?
Thank you. Thank you, Sandeep. And District Governor-elect Rajan. And of course, Director Kamal. I would like to tell you something about Kamal and Sonal and Ravi and Raji. Now, Kamal was the chairman for the Calcutta Institute. So immediately, I followed him at the Hyderabad Institute. Kamal was the guest chair at the Jaipur. Immediately, I was the guest chair at Dubai. Kamal was the international training leader. Immediately, I was the training leader. And Kamal is now the director. And thank God, I am following him again. So we have a very strong relationship. And I don't know whether this many coincidences can happen in leadership in Rotary. But Kamal and Sonal, you've been very close to us.
And of course, we admire you, Kamal, for your leadership. And we love both of you. I wish I would have come to Dhanbad. It was scheduled in April. And thank you, Rajan, for inviting me. But unfortunately, because of this COVID, I could not. But I'm here. So this is my second assembly to talk to all of you. Last time it was Gopal, and that was in Calcutta. And now it is, virtual thing. So if I do the third one, it will become adat. So hopefully I'll become an adat for you. I wish I can speak in that chaste Hindi that Kamal speaks. But of course, I will learn that now, because suddenly I find that unless you speak in Hindi, you will not be able to communicate with the Rotarians. So I will. My Hindi is a typical Hyderabadi filmy Hindi. So at this point, I would rather like not to speak about it. But I will now talk to you. And of course, Sanjay calls my wife as mother, mom. He's so close to us, Sanjay and Meenakshi. And he doesn't call me dad. I ask him why. No, you're not fit for that. So he has some very high standards for that. But Sanjay, you're doing some great job, and I know you'll be very successful for the Cochin Institute. And I wish, as always, we wish you and Meenakshi all the best. And thanks to everybody for being here, and especially Kamal for being here in the pets. I do wish that, and I hope that it is just to hear me that you are here. Anyway, on that, it was
there for that.
You know, I can always say that Kamal Bhaiya waited to hear me. You know, that's another brownie point for me. And thank you, Sonal. Now, today I've been asked by Rajan to talk to you about Rotaract and Interact and youth leadership. And he also quickly said, why don't you also talk about projects? And he also quickly said, why don't you talk about fundraising? I said, boss, listen, what do you want me to speak? I will speak. Then he said, okay, leadership and Rotaract and Interact. So first, I'm going to share my life story with Rotaract. You must have seen in my bio that Rotaract really changed me as a leader. I was a Rotaract president in the year 1977. I have learned so many things on leadership, and Rotaract and forming Rotaract clubs is the best thing that you as a president can do, my friends. And I would encourage every club in 3 to 50 to form at least 5 Rotaract clubs, 3 education-based clubs and 2 community-based clubs. And this is your last chance to form such clubs without subscription. But I'm sure, like I told you, once you form them and once they love Rotaract, they will be Rotaractors and they will pay the subscription, because subscription is very little, and we'll come to that later on. But before that, let me tell you my story about Rotaract. Rotaract, I was the Rotaract president in 77, and it changed my life. I became a better leader, better organizer, a better understanding of leadership skills, event management, organization skills, and all that. But the most important thing that Rotaract gave me, and this I want to know, how Rotaract can change people and as a changing life experience, is that Rotaract changed my life philosophy itself. It was in 77 when I attended the Asian Rotaract Convention, and Swami Chinmayananda was the speaker. He spoke on youth is the season of hope, enterprise and energy to a nation as well as an individual. And during his speech, he also spoke about goal setting. And then he told us that in life, always set goals so high that you can't reach them. Sitting in the audience, I was shocked, because at that time, all the management gurus, all our teachers used to say, you must set your goals and reach them. Set your goals and reach them. But then Swamiji has a reason. He said, set your goals so high that you will constantly strive and reach and acquire knowledge and work hard and try to reach. If you set your goals so low, you reach and you have nothing else to do. What a profound statement, my friends. And that remained etched in my memory. And till today, I follow that principle. And it has become my principle and philosophy in life. So Rotaract can change the youth. And I would encourage every president, every Rotary leader, every club leader present here in the PETS to start as many Rotaract clubs as possible and invest in the future for the youth and for Rotary. And I'm going to tell you what is happening in the survey of Rotaract. How are Rotaractors? One, Rotaractors are experts in their fields. In a community-based Rotaract club especially, and limits are boundless. You go to an industry, in fact, I was telling my Hyderabad Rotarians, they must go to Microsoft and form a Rotaract club of Microsoft with 1,000 members. It is possible. You can go to Deloitte in Hyderabad and form a Rotaract club of Deloitte with 20,000 members. It is possible, and I have done it. It is possible. Last year, I have formed Rotaract clubs in 10 engineering colleges with 20,000 Rotaractors. I personally went to all the colleges, explained to them what is Rotary, attended their assemblies, addressed their assemblies, and explained to them how important it is for them to join Rotaract. And lo and behold, after 7 to 8 days hard work, and of course the club members then took over, we formed 20,000 Rotaractors. And what did we do with them? We brought all of them to participate in a polio rally. All of them wore the red beautiful t-shirt of End Polio Now, and Director Bharat Pandya was the chief guest. What a fascinating sight it was to see 20,000 Rotaractors, the youth of this country, participating in such a rally, my friends. So set your goals so high so that you cannot reach them, was the philosophy. Of course, most of us, and Kamal Bhaiya knows, and Sandeep knows, and Sanjay knows, Rotaract also gave me Raji. That is the most important thing in my life, because we understand each other, and she has been my life partner and also a partner in Rotary. Imagine if she was not a Rotaract president at that time and I didn't meet her, then perhaps I would not have married Raji at all. So I owe my life to Rotaract. And so that is a big advantage, friends. Rotaract can be a marriage bureau for all we know. So go form Rotaract clubs. These two things have changed my life. So coming back to Rotaractors, Rotaractors today are experts in their field. When a survey was conducted of the Rotaractors in this world, they found that Rotaractors are deal makers, Rotaractors are transformers, Rotaractors are mediators, Rotaractors are expert recruiters, and Rotaractors are expert CEOs. In our own country, and our country represents almost 42% of the Rotaract population. And we have some excellent Rotaractors who are having industries. And especially now, Rotaract is no longer a program of Rotary. Rotaract is a member of Rotary International, a Rotaractor. So this changes the whole dimension of Rotaract movement. And I think Rotaract is going to give us new enthusiasm, new energy. So Rotaractors are giving new energy and new enthusiasm into the whole concept of membership. Imagine if 10 Rotaractors join Rotary immediately at the age of 28 or 29. They bring fresh ideas, they bring fresh enthusiasm, they bring fresh energy, and more importantly, they change the whole dimension of your club. They will become the pillars of the strength of your club. So if you form Rotaract now, please be ensured that 2 years later on, your club will become a dynamic, vibrant club, because these Rotaractors will join your club. What a fascinating idea, friends. So go form clubs, at least 5 Rotaract clubs. In fact, I promised Shekhar Da, you know, our favorite Rotary leader, Kamal and me always say that one of us is a right hand, one of us is a left hand. Shekhar Da never tells who is the right or who is the left, but never mind, both of us are his hands. So I promised Shekhar Da that by the end of his year, at the end of his tenure, I will give him 1 million Rotaractors in India at home. Today, we have just about 2 lakh Rotaractors. Isn't it a shame, friends? We have 1,60,000 Rotarians and we have 3,000 plus clubs, almost 4,000 clubs, and we do not have Rotaract as many as Rotaractors. Imagine if each Rotary club forms 5 Rotaract clubs, what would be the strength of Rotaract? That is the future of Rotary. So what are Rotaractors doing otherwise? They know how to recruit Rotarians because they have the networking capacity. You and I, you know, have lost track on getting Rotarians or young Rotarians. You want to grow young, you have to bring Rotaractors into our fold. So I would encourage that use their talent because they are expert recruiters. And this I want to also share, my friends. They bring solutions to complex problems in a creative way. I think the time has come for Rotarians to think creatively in project implementation. I mean, we are still following the same old rules of project implementation. By the way, my philosophy about project implementation or project resources is very simple. And that philosophy, especially on fundraising and large projects, is first have the concept. First have the concept note ready. First have the plan. First have the cause. First have the concern. First have the compassion. And then resources will automatically flow. So, of course, I will talk to you more detailedly later on when the next time I come to you and talk about projects and project implementation. But never mind, Rotaract will do that. Rotaract will also give you a new idea on project implementation. In my life, I have seen youngsters giving us new project ideas and changing the whole dimension in that. In the year 1996, and this is a personal story, friends, I would like to share with you, I wanted to build 100 schools across the country. School building has always been my passion. And I made a typical plan of 2 classrooms, 1 veranda, and I wanted to build 100 schools all over the country. Each school was costing 5 lakhs in those days. Being a chartered accountant, I broke that budget into bricks and mortar and cement, how much steel you need and all that. And I was very excited. In fact, I went with the project report to Mother Teresa and sought her blessings. And then she told me, believe in yourself and automatically things will happen. She also said, the power of prayer will move mountains. These two philosophies I learned from Mother Teresa. But that apart, that's another story. When I was discussing this idea of building schools with ICICI Bank and with the Manthan Group, one young girl came up to me and said, Ravi, why do you want to build schools? Listen to this, my friends, very clearly. Ravi, why do you want to build schools? So I told her, I want to build schools because I want young people who are studying under the trees to be habituated and, you know, they'll go to a school where they can study well and things like that. Then she asked me, what are the kind of schools you are building? Then I told her, we are typically building a 2 classrooms, 1 veranda, 1 staff room, 1 toilet block kind of a school. Then she asked me, to whom are you building these schools? I told her, it is for the poor of this country. Friends, she asked me a very pertinent question, a Rotaractor. She asked me, why should the poor of this country study in only poor schools? Why should the poor of this country study in poor schools? Your children and my children go to schools with huge playground, huge classrooms, and sometimes air conditioned, more often than not now air conditioned. And why should poor children go to poor schools? I had no answer. I said, I do not have the money. Then she said, why do you need the money? I said, to build schools. Then she asked me, why should you build schools? And I said, why? I want to give education to children. Then she told me that why can't we use the existing schools like St. Ignatius, Loyola, St. Joseph's, Delhi Public School and all those big schools in the evening after 4 o'clock, take the slum children there and use the same premises to study. What a creative solution to a complex problem. Then, like a typical Rotarian, like all of you and me, I was also very young at that time. I asked, but who will give? Then she looked up to me, eyes with a glint, and said, who asked? Friends, the secret is you must learn to ask. The secret is you must believe in yourself. The secret is there is always a solution to complex problems. So I would encourage you to get creative by encouraging Rotaract clubs. This is one of the biggest things that can happen. So what will Rotaract do? First, it will harness technology to you. I am digitally illiterate. I am only learning Zoom and virtual platform thanks to the COVID. In fact, 10 days back, I thought, in 1974, when I went to the public speaking classes, the first lesson they told us is practice before a mirror. Practice before a mirror to make a good public speech. So I know Kamal will agree with me. We are doing the same thing now. I'm seeing my own face and practicing for talking to myself while making a speech. I think the circle is complete now, thanks to the platform, is what I was thinking. Anyway, jokes apart, friends. So they will harness technology for you. That is one. And two, and most importantly, new methods of fundraising will happen. Sanjay was talking about fundraising. All of them are time tested. All of them will work. But what about the new COVID challenges? What about tomorrow, when suppose we will not be allowed to form a carnival? What about when we will not be crowded? You know, we have to make social distancing. All of us have to wear masks. How do we create funds? Friends, an organization called Global Citizen has raised $127 million in one night on a musical concert called Together at Home. Together at Home for COVID-19. Creativity. They had Lady Gaga, and I'm sure my friend Sandeep will know. Sandeep is good about all this music and other things. I don't know about these things. But I was told Lady Gaga is one of those popular singers. So Lady Gaga led the show and they made $127 million on one night. So what is the moral for us? The moral is that there are new ways to raise funds. The moral is that unless we have young people with us, we cannot raise those kind of funds. So if you want creativity in projects, if you want creativity in fundraising, if you want creativity in fellowship, if you want creativity in your club administration, if you want fresh ideas, if you want energy and enthusiasm, please form Rotaract clubs, who will then become Rotary members. Forming Rotaract clubs is your duty to invest in the future. And I would encourage each one of you to form 5 Rotaract clubs each. Very simple. 18 to 30 institutions, community-based, do surveys, have a business plan, and you must do those Rotaract clubs. Interact, of course, is a school-based club. And I will tell you one story about how school children are very powerful. Friends, I'll tell you, Interact is form. You can form easily 5 Interact clubs because there is no subscription at all. 9th and 10th children should be there so that there will be continuity. One dedicated Rotarian who likes children and school children should be attached, and they will form clubs, and they don't need to meet regularly. All they need to do mandatorily is 2 projects, one for their school or community and one an international project. So forming Interact clubs will actually lay the seeds for them to become Rotaractors and then later on Rotarians. I would encourage every club to form these Interact clubs. And friends, I met a friend of mine from Canada called Craig. You know, he runs a beautiful program called Me to We. Me to We with school children. Every year, he encourages school children. His theme is very simple. All school children, apart from studies, should become good human beings. Every parent would want it. Each of you who are parents would want it. I would want my grandson to be a good humanitarian. So I'm actually encouraging him to join Rotary. So friends, each school child should be sensitized to
past service. District governor, he was so the regional was on journey as a guilty member. Ravi Vadlamani is a 17 to 2000. Several large, several lift international conventions.
80,000 children. A beautiful concept. The concept which enables him to build villages. A concept which enables him to do service. So we can learn from these kind of a people, young people. So I would encourage every club also to form interact clubs. Friends, I think I'm running against time. So I once again thank Rajan. And if Gopal is around, I would also like to say hi. And of course, thank you Kamal Bhaiya and Sonal for being here. And Sanjay and Sandeep and all my friends. I have seen Mahesh, of course, thank you for being here. I don't know who are the other past governors, but I thank each one of them for inviting me to your district once again. And I would like to, next time I come, my friends, I promise you, I would like to speak in chaste Hindi like Kamal Bhaiya. And Kamal Bhaiya, it is your botheration now to teach me that chaste Hindi, which you always use to quote, you know, whenever you make your lovely, lovely speeches. Thank you very much, friends. And once again, thank you, Rajan.
Thank you so much, Ravi. It was fantastic. And there were some fresh ideas thrown in. You carried the subject. Sanjay had started and it was fabulous. Rajan, you'd like to make a comment?
Yeah, definitely. Ravi, we are so inspired because actually we need a lot of interact and road track clubs in our district. The way you have given the vision and you have given some solutions, how to road track help build up everything. I think this has been very well taken by all the presidents of the clubs. And we will say a beautiful change coming in our district as far as the young leadership is going to come up. Next time, we would definitely like to have your vision on this large projects, which you are famous for worldwide. Thank you so much for being with us and inspiring us.
Thank you, Ravi.
Ravi, we are at the end of the day, and we started the evening with a fancy dress competition.
Okay. And
we have some prizes to be given, and Kamal is also here, and you are also here. I would like you to stay for the next 5 to 7 minutes.
Yeah, I have no problem. And
our winners will be very happy to be recognized in your presence.
Oh, yes.
So please stay back with us. So friends, moving on. I have some good news and bad news again at the end of the day, like every day. We had the COVID beard competition, but the COVID beard competition has been moved to Wednesday.
So you can grow a bit more of the beard.
So we have moved this to Wednesday when we have the, kya maine bola tha, parishisht bhag, the epilogue or the postscript to our pets and sets, which is on Wednesday, 13th of May. So hamare jo bhi entrants the, beard competition ke liye, I'm sorry, Moen and the others, we will do it on Wednesday at 6 o'clock on Wednesday on the 13th of May. और आपको मैं बता दूं उसके लिए आपको यू विल बी गिवन द स्पॉटलाइट और आपको शायद आपका चेहरा आगे से साइड से दोनों तरफ से दिखाना पड़ेगा टू आर एस्टीम्ड जजेस. मीनवाइल द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ द फैंसी ड्रेस कॉम्पिटिशन इज देयर एंड कैन आई रिकग्नाइज फर्स्ट द जजेस हु डन अ टेरिफिक जॉब. वी हैव द फर्स्ट जज वाज सोनल. कैन यू पुट द स्पॉट ऑन सोनल? Narendra, can you put the spot on Sonal? Sonal Sanghvi or Narendra, can you hear me? Yeah, there they are. And of course, our judges were Meenakshi Khemka, Sanjay Meenakshi, I can see them. Yeah, there they are. And of course, our third judge was Shilpi Chachan. Is Shilpi there? I'm not sure. Okay, and we had one of the most, there should be. Ravi is one of the most dynamic current presidents of this particular year. And so then we have, before the results, is there something else? And of course, there's a song at the end of the day. This year again there will be prize winners. I would recognize yesterday's prize winners for who participated in the ending song for Rotarian, Ajit Kumar.
I wrote the same.
Dr. Ajit Kumar, but I don't see him today. Words. And we had Rajan Jain.
Thanks, love.
Narendra, if you can see them, you can put the spotlight on Rajan Jain and Dr. Ajit Kumar. Okay. And I've just got a message from incoming First Lady Anju that we are going to have a spouses session also, a 2-hour spouses session, which the details will follow soon. So I'll now get to Anu to announce the results of the fancy dress competition. I think I'll try to start from the special mentions. Everyone did a great job, friends, and Narendra, if you can spot these people who took part. Our assistant governor, who part of it, didn't come because there was a medical emergency. Arun Verma ji, can we put this up? He's now here.
He's here.
Arun Verma ji, is he there? Yes. Oh, aap, to meko laga aap shayad dress mein bhi aaye honge, but nevertheless, so now we announce, Anu, can you announce the prize winners?
Hi, good evening, friends. Everybody did a wonderful job. I think hum logo ghar baith ke dekhne